The officials make the calls in accordance with the basketball rulebook. First, let's take a look at fouls that can be called on an offensive player.
Offensive foul. Glenn Rice Jr. is L.A. Tenorio. Got rocked a little bit.
Sa offensive player, meron kang sariling space. Basketball is a game of space, so yung space mo dapat respected by the defensive player. You protect the ball, pwedeng may contact, pero hindi excessive.
Nice pass to Junmar Bahard, who misses the gimme. Okay, now Marshall Lester will be called for an offensive foul.
The most common foul that an offensive player can commit is the charging foul. This usually happens when the defender is defending so well, the player with the ball inadvertently makes excessive contact with the defender.
Close by and then, offensive foul!
When an offensive player comes or drives straight into the basket, tapos illegal basketball move yung ginawa niya, usually charging or an offensive foul is called.
Now it's San Miguel in transition. And Santos will be called for an offensive foul.
For example, player A has already established his stationary position when offensive player B knocked him over while trying to go to the basket.
And Santos will be called for an offensive foul.
The offensive player is entitled to the space in front, side of him, and at the back, no, up to one step forward. So pagka one step forward, you prevent him, okay lang yun, nauna ka dun. So kailangan umiwas siya sa'yo. One classic example, yung tatawid papasok sa shaded area galing sa baseline. Ang ginagawa ng offensive player, papasok siya nang wala nang space na pwedeng puntahan yung defensive player. Ang dapat na gawin ng defensive player, apakan niya yung baseline, pero ang apak niya paatras, hindi pa side. Kasi pag side niya, sabay silang dumating doon, foul siya. So pag paatras ang apak niya sa baseline, tumama yung offensive player sa kanya, offensive foul yun.
Those are the things that'll spark up your energy.
That is a clear offensive.
The other type of the most common offensive foul is the illegal back screen. As a general rule, the screener should remain stationary. Let's check this play out. The screener followed the rule when he allowed the opponent to take one step backward without making contact. The foul was called when the screener failed to remain in his position. According to the refs, staying still and respecting space are all there is to it.
Well, the player shouldn't move at all while or once the screen is being used. Another thing would be not to extend any part of the body outside of what we call the player cylinder. So if you're within your cylinder and then you don't extend any extremities or any of your limbs or your butt or a knee, then that's the most preventive measure you can do as an offensive player.
Baseline, no good. Kelly has it. Running the break for TNT. Ball almost taken away by Lassiter, but a foul is whistled.
Coaches always tell players to go after the ball and not the handler. Why? Because you can be called for a defensive foul.
May mga fouls na useless. Kasi imbis na may effort ka para kunin yung bola, galaw-gaw lang yung depensa. Masyadong malapit yung pagkuha niya ng bola, natatamaan niya yung opensa. Pag sa depensa, you just stay in front. Kasi pag naiwanan ka, yung teammate mo na isa, siya ang dapat mag-cover.